when you say people, you are referring for the most to practitioners.
Yes.
Because it seems that the bigger resistance is from them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because it's a client, of course, if they see something that works and that works better, and for better I don't mean efficacy, because as you say, efficacy could be almost the same, probably a little more, or let's say the same of other therapies, but the efficiency, how many sessions do you need to accomplish your steps to get the results, is very different. Because I read that CBT lasts around 12 to 20, an average of 12 to 20 sessions, which is surprising to me, because from my experience, it's a lot more session needed for a CBT therapy, but it's my impression. I don't do CBT, I just research says that it's around 12 to 16 to 12 to 20, 16, 20, which is good, but researchers say that solution focus is around 3 to 6, the average 3 to 6 sessions.
Yeah.
Which is good for clients, it's good for healthcare systems, especially in this historical moment. I'm talking about this very precise moment with coronavirus, etc. I mean, this era, these decades in which whole the healthcare system in the world are in crisis, because it's one of the biggest expense that the governments have in a country.
Yes.
What do you think could be a good way to help professionals and institutions to accept solution focus, to at least know more about solution focus?
Yes, it's very difficult to get the ideas into people's minds, so they will think about it, even if they don't do it, but they will know what the conversation is about. The traditional method is teaching. You know, you have learned teachers and they go around speaking to everybody and are convincing. Somehow people believe what they say and then copy it. I'm sometimes at workshops by big experts and people are saying, oh, they are astonished. Yeah, the view changes completely. Not so much in my teaching, I don't think, but with some of these other people, yeah, the very famous ones, you see dramatic changes during the workshop. People will say, oh, yes, we can do it that way. So you have the impression of a conversion, like a religious conversion? Suddenly, new idea. And that helps, but it will take 20 years, 30 years for us to convince everybody. Yes. So teaching is the obvious way. Publicity. Government publicity for CBT in Britain has not made it more popular. And also the success rate is very low. So that's also not made it very popular. They are lucky if they get 50% success in the British setting. So that doesn't encourage people to use CBT, because they see it's not good. But that means to get them to do something else like solution focused. We have to show them that it is having success, it is producing good results for people. Which just took me back to research. If I just say this is good, nobody will believe me. Why they believe me? But if we have researches carried out properly, which show that something is successful, must convince learned people, people like yourself, people like psychologists and doctors, if they see real research, perhaps they will believe it.
Yeah. This is why I had to confess, this kind of interviews, this kind, are the less popular because, therapists, they want to know about techniques, about what can I do with this kind of client. They don't want to know about research. But again, those are my favorite interviews because, you just learned new techniques, but do you know if that kind of technique can work with your clients? And common factors say that we hold the therapies are equivalent in efficacy, and it's been saying since 1938, if I remember well, the Dodd verdict. So probably yes. you want to switch to something that is more. More rapid, more brief, a couple of questions again. There are some kind of filed area in which you prefer to work and to do research. So what are your favorite kind of researches in solution focusing? Which areas, with which clients, the most interesting results that you discover in these years?
I think the most useful in this mode. Everyday clients we would all see often, because to work with serious mental illness is very interesting, but not so many people do that. So they will not want to know if it's easier or more difficult. Numbers of sessions. When I was teaching family therapy, I was strategic therapist, but we saw Steve DeShazer work and we thought, well, let us try this for 6 months and see if it is better than what we do already. And of course it was much better, and we found more respectful and not so many sessions. So there was a clear practical difference for the clinic, that we could see more clients more quickly. Mm-hmm. But we were allowed to make those decisions, whereas not every hospital allows you to do that, not every clinic. So it was good to, you could demonstrate that you could have success more quickly. And if people see that, then they became more willing to take part in it. But many of my psychiatrist colleagues said to me, oh, you are very good at talking with people. I said, well, it's not me, it's the technique, it's the solution focused. You could learn it. They, oh, no, it's you that does it. So it was very difficult to actually get them to try. And I don't know how you change that. I was there doing it and they still wouldn't believe enough to try it. It's like being a missionary. Yeah, you are spreading the knowledge of the gospel, but nobody is paying attention. So it's difficult.
Yeah, I can see. I have a last question, and this is a question I always do in every interview. So, imagine that tomorrow, no, imagine that, imagine that you want to, how to say, to give a suggestions to, it's not very solution focused, to the therapist, to psychotherapist, to give a suggestion about an exercise that they can do outside in their common life, in their everyday life, and is a suggestion to be a better therapist. What is your suggestion?
I suggest that as an experiment for a week, every time you talk with anybody, you use some of their words in your responses. Doesn't matter which word, but always do that in every conversation. If you are buying ticket from bus driver, or if you are talking to professional colleague, or talking to your wife, use the same word, and often you will see a difference immediately. And they'll say, oh, he pays attention.
Yeah.
I have done this in prisons and in places, and they say, oh, you're listening. You know, I don't know so much about what they do. So
yeah.
It produces a response, something I think in the brain about speech makes a connection. So that would be my idea.
I like it. To use their words and see what happens. I like it, and this is, I have to say that this is one of my favorite experiments, suggestion, because it's easy, it's affordable by everyone who will see this interview can immediately use this, and it's a very good practice to be a better therapist. Yeah, okay, perfect.
That's
that. Yep.
I hope you can find that useful and get people to do it, because I think it makes a big change in people's working skill.
Yeah, I bet that. I really believe that. Yeah. Thank you so much, Alasdair. It was very interesting. I hope it will be useful to spread solution focus more and more around the world, and to give some ideas about how to work with solution focus therapy. You also have written some books, which I honestly suggest to people. And so, thank you again. See you next time.
Yes, thank you. Good luck with your endeavors. Yeah, send my best wishes to Italy. It's my beautiful country. Yeah. Okay, signing off then. Goodbye for now.
Bye.